Hello students, welcome back to another session on agro-processing industries. So far we have discussed the role of agro-processing industries, the types of agro-processing industries, what are the challenges in processing, what are the opportunities, threats, everything, the SWOT analysis, the kinds of different types of processing industries, everything have been discussed. So today now we will discuss on certain plans and strategies to develop agro-processing industry which are lacking, in which the processing industry. We will check what are the major areas where the Indian processing industries are lacking, and we will discuss on the plans and strategies to develop agro processing industries. So one among them is the contract farming. So what happens in contract farming is, to get uniform and quality of raw material for the food processing, this contract farming plays an important role. These companies provide seeds of desired varieties, other agricultural inputs and other guidelines to the farmers, and then buy the raw material from those farmers at a pre-negotiable prices. Just like the Lays, what they do is they give the seeds to the farmers and they grow the potatoes, and finally the raw potatoes are directly from the field are being harvested and taken to the factory. Just like the Suguna Chicken, and HUL is also having certain contract farming tie-ups. The farmers are also happy as they get fixed returns regardless of the market fluctuation. Example are Suguna Poultry Farm, Hindustan Unilever, Tata Rallis, ICIC. Okay, so they are all promoting the contract farming. Next is institutional finance is a kind of strategy to help the agro processing industries and to develop the processing industry. Unless availability of institutional finance or the investment is there is a good amount of financial finance available, the industry cannot meet the needs. So what happens, the industry cannot meet the needs and the growth of the industry will not happen. Although of late the government seems to have realized this, and the Ministry of Food Processing Industry have declared the sector as a priority sector for providing the credit. And since it is being provided with credit, there are certain tax exemptions, income tax exemptions provided to the agro-processing industries and agro-processing units. Next is comprehensive law. Urgent need of the comprehensive law. There is existent urgent requirement in the comprehensive law of the food processing industry. At present, what happens, there is a plethora of laws and agencies that govern this in the this processing industry. The government has proposed Processed Food Development Act to support this processing industry. It aims to put in a place a single window service that would bring all the provisions relating to the food processing under one umbrella and one authority, thus removing the existing all kind of difficulties and problems. The act also aims to consolidate the various standards of quality and also harmonize them with international standards. Next, we will see what are the strategies to be adopted in the quality control. Quality control is another key to success in the international. Consumers are extremely quality conscious. So Indian quality standards should be benchmarked against the international standards like Codex. And at present, the products like fruit pulp, fruit juice concentrate, the frozen, the dehydrated one, the canned meat, poultry and marine products are among the main processed products being exported from India. So to improve the export, we have to give more importance to the quality. The list could grow much longer if the products are certified for the quality. Now coming, speaking about the proper packaging. The packaging of food items is most essential aspect of food processing, and here lies the most cost involved in processing industry. It has a very important role to play, that of attracting the consumer's attraction today's competitive scenario. The packaging has become an integrated part of the brand management. For like, packaging is the first thing that a person or a consumer sees, or that makes him attracted towards that particular product. So packaging has become an integrated part part of the brand development and brand management. As apart from having an aesthetic appeal, the packaging has another important roles, such as it maintains the flavor, it protects the product from other things, the climate, the moisture and all other kind of things. Okay, next is the national plan. National plan for the improvement and extension of agro processing technology should be implemented and should be more strict. It should take into account the diversity in resources and needs of different regions in the country. It also should include the program details and implementation schedule for the first 4 or 5 years. The progresses of plan implementation should be periodically reviewed to allow adjustments and corrective measures. Okay, and we'll discuss on the thrust areas for the research and development. It should be identified, and medium term research and development program should be prepared and implemented to support the national plan for the improvement and extension of agro processing technologies at different level. The treatment and utilization of effluents from the agro processing industry should be included in the research and development. We know, like, once just after the processing, there are a large number of effluents or the waste material are being piled up. So there should be certain research and developmental activities carried, so that the treatment and proper utilization of the waste from the processing industries can be it can also result into an income source. Now, speaking about the establishment of new agro processing industrial plants in the production at catchments to minimize the transport cost, to make use of lower coastland, more abundant water supply, create employment opportunity in the rural sector, and utilize the process waste and byproducts for feed or irrigation or manure. Speaking about the infrastructure in production catchments, in relation to the production selected for the agro industrial development should be improved. Because of the uncertain grid power supply into the rural areas, centralized power generation using locally available resources may become an integral part of the agro industrial development. Most of the food processing industries of India are located in the rural areas, and they are facing a strict problem of a serious problem of this power supply. Similarly, if the raw materials are processed products, are perishable or semi-perishable in nature, and they have a cold chain well established with them. So if they have a well-established cold storage or warehouse facilities, the deterioration may reduce. And financial incentives and support should be provided on liberal scale to promote the modernization of agro processing industries for establishing new such industries in the production and processing channel. Next, arrangements to the supply market information to the farmers and agro processors should be put in priority. So by this we conclude the session, and if you feel any difficulty, get back to me. Thank you.